difficulties than any other team. Acknowledged as being one of the finest players in the game, for the last 2 years he's been skipper, and he has scuppered all the opposition in a winning run that has put the club into the record books. His family tree has its roots in Scotland, but he's part New Zealand Maori with international honours. This is his farewell season before he kicks off for a new team back on the other side of the world. The final siren will be the signal for my one-man invasion of the pitch, and I have to tell you, I'm a bit worried about this one, because there are a lot of tough lads out there, and if I get the wrong one, I'm going to be trampled underfoot. Girls, I shall be right behind you, OK? Good evening.
Evening.
Hello, Dean. Good evening, Central Park.
What's going on?
Now, it's your teammates, one or two of them know about this, Dean, but not many of them. It's a surprise for most, because I've come here tonight to say, tonight, Wigan skipper, Dean Bell, this is your life. See you later. I'll take that back to you for now.
I feel as though I've got concussed and this is a dream.
Eh?
I feel as though I've got concussed and this is a dream.
Well, you'll find out it isn't very soon. Can I just say what's going to happen now? What we are going to do now is take Dean back to another team lineup in Manchester. So we have to leave Wigan. And thank you very much. You'll watch and see the show on the air. But we have to take a very late bath. Dean, are you game?
Yeah, sure am.
Great. Come with me. Well, here, scrubbed and powdered, your Wigan teammates and the vital prop on your home side, your wife, Jackie. Now, the Cherry and Whites have won almost everything recently, including the team trophy at last year's Variety Club Sports Award, an occasion which inspired one of your biggest fans.
And I've been in training ever since.
From television's new comedians, it is Eddie Collington. Eddie, so the training is obviously going very well.
Well, actually, I'm not really overweight. I'm just too short. No, I checked the chart in the chemist, and according to the chart, it should be 17 foot 8. Oh, seriously. I met Dean and the boys at the Variety Club dinner last year at Manchester, and I said, do you like to see Wigan? I live near Wigan in Skelmersdale, and delighted to see all the boys doing well. I wish you all very well for the future. And if you want to keep the training going, boys, you can come to my Keep Fat classes. All the very best to you.
Thank you, Eddie Collington.
Any of these three seats?
Those three at the end are yours, brother. Well, Dean, the bulk of the Bell clan are based 12,000 miles away in New Zealand, but here is a trio for your front row tonight. Your father, Cameron, your mother, Janice, and your sister, Tracy. Well, someone who played for the away side earlier tonight has also had his share of glory in a cherry and white shirt. Formerly your captain at Wigan, now captain of Leeds, one of the game's greats, Ellery Hanley. So, Ellery, you've known Dean as an ally and as an opponent.
That's right. I think Dean's probably one of the most respected players in the game. I mean, I played against Dean right back in 1984. We've had some tremendous battles. And I've played with him as well. He's been a total professional. I've learned a lot from Dean, and I think he's done excellent, you know, and he deserves everything what's been given to him today.
Well said. Thank you. Ellery Hanley.
Thank you, sir.
Well, Dean, this is your farewell season over here. You've signed for the Auckland Warriors back home in New Zealand, where you'll be joining another Wigan hero, former coach John Mooney. As you know, he's busy right now down under preparing the team. And since you joined Wigan in 1986, you've notched up 96 tries and lifted a stack of silverware. You're New Zealand Player of the Year in 1987, and the 1991 season sees you voted the English League's Man of Steel for your outstanding contribution to the game. And congratulations on another win tonight, of course. Now here is Dean Bell and Wigan in typical action. Well, that's great stuff. Well, Dean Cameron Bell, personal motto, life is not a rehearsal. This is your life. You were born on April the 29th, 1962, in Auckland on New Zealand's North Island. You go to Mayfield Primary School, believe it or not. That is the boy who grew up to be known as Mean Dean. You have a reputation as Mean Dean, I believe.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Well, I can ask a few lads over here, I expect. Well, as is the way in New Zealand, you're quick to take to rugby, picking up your first ball at the age of four. Your training ground is the Manukau Club outside Auckland, and your progress is a family business. You're coached by your father and uncles, all club stalwarts. But, Tracy, there's another sport, I think, in the family blood.
That's right. My grandfather immigrated to New Zealand from Scotland, where he coached football.
That's the round ball, isn't
yeah.
it? As it happens, Dean, at Hillary College, you excel, of course, at all sport. You move quickly through the ranks at Manukau, soon making it to the first team. Cameron, the family gave Dean some punishing workouts.
Oh, we certainly did, Mike. We come from a long line of rugby players, and we certainly dished it out to him, but he took it, and he had no other option but to take it.
Yeah.
And he's certainly come through, and he's done us proud.
Well, you leave school at 16, and early jobs are at a meat packers and a tyre factory. Your spare time is devoted, of course, to rugby. In 1982, age 20, word of Dean Bell reaches England's outback.
Carlisle, here we come.
In fact, they're in Manchester tonight. More of the rugby dynasty from New Zealand. Your uncle, former Kiwi and Maori star Ian Bell, and your cousin Clayton Friend. So, Ian is from the North Island of New Zealand to the north of England.
Yeah, well, as you know, Dean Carlisle were a newly promoted team and they're looking for a couple of good players, so they bought me and Clayton.
And fortunately enough, we bought you. But you went on to bigger and better things than as we knew you would.
Good one, mate.
Thank you, fellas, very much. Well, it was a slow start in Carlisle, but you certainly made up for that, and here is the evidence.
And a break by Bell, and not for the first time. He's going to score for Carlisle.
Now, another reason for that being a memorable time is sitting next to you. You meet and fall for supporter Jackie Parker. You introduce her to the folks in Auckland, and after touring England with the Maori side and signing for Leeds, you marry on December the 2nd, 1983, at St John's Church, Upperby. Jackie, you had no doubts about Dean's commitment to the game.
No, that's right. We were married on the Friday, and Dean turned out for Leeds the next day, so I knew straight away.
And that wasn't the only time, was it?
No, when our second child was born, I went into labour at 2 o'clock in the morning, and I had her at 12 at lunchtime, and Dean was on the team bus at 3 o'clock that afternoon for a game.
Well, he does celebrate the birth of his second child by playing a blinder.
Oh, love a short ball by Edwards to Bell.
Remarkable football. Buttica for the corner. Bell has the walk-in. Second try to Dean Bell.